How do I handle Master Arik?
Well, you train like mad so you can beat him, or...
Or what?
Or you train and you talk to Casper. He's got a few tricks up his sleeve.
Stop there, brother.
I've got some stew, but you can't have it.
Then I'm not letting you in.
Is there anything else we can trade?
I wanted that stew. That stew is one of the few little pleasures in this place. Sorry, but if anything happened in there, I'd be cleaning out the cesspits for a month. Why should I risk that if I don't get anything?
You needn't worry. I'll be fine in there.
It's not you I'm worried about. It's the artifacts.
Is there anything I can give you to get into the cemetery?
I'll think about it. Unless you think of something first. Something that would be worth my risk. Hey, you can't enter here. I don't want to fight, but I can't let you in.
Looks like I'm going to have to fight against Master Arik.
Don't fancy your chances.
Can you help me?
Against Arik. Arik's decent, but he's had a dodgy past, and somewhere during it he got himself a charmed sword. You don't stand a chance while he's got that. Blades are frowned on here, but the Inquisition turn a blind eye when it's Arik. The recruits need training, and right now he is the best trainer around.
I'm betting words alone won't get this sword off him.
No. He does loosen up after a drink, though. Only time I've heard him talk about his past. And talking about his past gets him talking about fights he's had.
And that'll work?
Sure. Once he's drunk a few bottles, then hit him with the hard stuff. Something that'll disconnect his mouth from his brain. If he starts bragging, you might be able to get that sword off him. You could even get him to take a handicap. Give him a lousy weapon. Let him prove himself to you.
They don't like blades here, so how can I get a bad one?
Maybe Karlsen, our smith, has something knocking about.
Where can I get some hard stuff?
Dalman's your man for that. He has all sorts in the cellar. Wine and mage wines. They have a powerful kick. They're said to contain actual magic. Try that, and a couple of jugs of regular wine first to soften him up.
What do you tell someone who cares?
Hey, you've been sent to relieve me. About time. I'm dog tired.
You want me to muck out dung?
I thought you were here to relieve me. Come on. I wouldn't ask you to do it for nothing.
What are you offering?
I'll give you a bottle of something special, a bottle of fire flush.
Why are you digging a dung heap? Did you upset someone?
No, it just needs to be done. So they send someone of my talents to shovel shit for days. It's about time somebody else took care of this crap.
What's fire flush?
It's a mage wine. One you have to be careful of.
Strong, is it?
Blow your socks off and curl your toes at the same time. And very difficult to get hold of.
What would I want with special wine?
keep it for a special occasion. I mean, if you were to give this to a special someone, they'd feel great. A couple of sips, they wouldn't know what they were saying. It's a mage wine to save for special occasions, is Fireflush. I mean, I can get you wine as well, but this is your wine plus, your wine extra, your wink and your nod.
Do you look after the wine cellar?
I have the noble title of Mage's Cellar Master. I received the wine cellar key from Master Ignatius himself.
I'll buy a bottle of wine.
Great pleasure to meet another connoisseur.
So what do the mages think about you trading their wine?
They don't mind. They have other things to worry about. The future looks rather grim as I see it, so why not crack open a bottle or two? So, if you ever need it, I can slip you a couple of bottles.
Thanks. I'll remember that.
Yes, and if you need special abilities, shall we say, I'm your man.
What special abilities?
Ones that not every warrior of the Order has.
Such as?
I'm talking about dexterity, sleight of hand, relieving pockets of their burden.
Oh, right, I see. I'll see if I can find someone to relieve you.
You won't leave me up shit creek, as it were. All right, I'll give you the bottle I promised, on trust. I trust you, right? You have an honest face. Mine, so do most of the thieves I know. New. It's their dishonest hands you have to worry about. Get hold of a novice to take my place. They're usually made to sweep up anyway.
What can you teach me? Help me improve my dexterity.
You're learning.
Help me improve my dexterity.
At least something's sinking in.
Help me improve my dexterity.
You're learning.
Help me improve my dexterity.
At least something's sinking in.
Halt, stranger. Until Master Vitus gives you permission, you'll have to stay out of the upper area of the monastery.
Keep your hands where I can see them. Come back later.
You can relieve Dalman from his work, Casper.
What work?
Digging over the dung heap.
Yeah. Thanks for that job opportunity. I think I'll pass.
I'll have to pick this, or find the key. I'm looking for some kind of really bad weapon. Something lousy, something rusty.
Are you trying to insult me?
No, I'm serious. I need something really lousy.
Look, I don't make lousy weapons.
I know you're a good smith.
Damn right.
I'm not questioning your abilities, but don't you have some rusty old specimen knocking about?
Maybe. Yeah. Perhaps there's one. I've got something made by one of me witless apprentices.
You have?
It's old and rusty. I only keep it to show people exactly how not to make swords.
That's exactly what I want.
But it's heavy, unwieldy, and dull. It's probably the worst sword in the world.
And that's exactly what I'm looking for.
Well, I'll let you have it. But don't tell anyone I gave it to you.
Quiet. I'm thinking.
Don't you have something to do?
I knew that. There's something here about magic. Now, who could teach me to pick locks? I knew that. Now, who could teach me to pick locks?
Years ago, not seen her since. Dreamt of her, not seen her. Storm.
Don't touch anything.
Now I'm here, can I leave the monastery?
Yes, from time to time. But believe me, you're safer in here.
So, how do I leave the monastery?
Master Pallas opens the gate, but he'll only do that once Master Ignatius considers you worthy.
Master Ignatius, huh? Caleb told me about him.
You'll meet him soon enough.
Hey, Taylor. It's time for you to take care of the dung heap.
And what are you offering?
Offering?
Well, I've no problem with getting dirty, but everything has a price.
What's your price for dealing with the dung heap?
Harlock stew. It's about the only decent thing to eat in here, and he only makes it once in a blue moon.
And you want my share?
Yes.
For a task you're supposed to do anyway.
Okay, fine. Then just bring me 10 apples instead. Fruit keeps you regular. You don't want to be corked up in a place like this.
Show me what you've got. Here are the apples you wanted.
Thanks. I'll get down the dung heap right away.
What do you want here?
Now, who could teach me to pick locks?
Quiet. I'm thinking.
You've been to Madame Sonia's this month. I hear there are some real sweetmeats to taste down there. Refugees with no money. Fresh fish.
How are you doing? Any word on a replacement excrement relocation officer?
I found you a new shit shoveler, if that's what you mean.
I know, I've seen them. Thank you. I'd better go and check on the wine. Harlock has some top quality wine. I'd better taste it. Make sure it's not gone off.
Why not try a few? Make doubly sure. Give me the key to the cellar.
This is no mere cellar key. It's the key to utter bliss.
Then give me the key to bliss.
You might as well ask me to tear out my heart and hand it to you.
Look, I only want to borrow it.
No, absolutely out of the question.
Things in the ruins, things in the woods. There are things everywhere.
Got this bottle of wine. Maybe we can have a drink, a talk.
I didn't ask you to bring me wine.
No, but as a master, you deserve it.
I shouldn't. Doesn't bring out the best in me. Ah, hell's been a long week. Go ahead.
So, you're a pretty good sword fighter.
Just pretty good? I think one of the boys must have hit you a bit too hard. Come on, let's go to the arena. I'll show you what pretty good is.
That's on his ears. You know how his ears stick out. Almost pulled them clean off.
You don't know who you're messing with.
Can't go on like this. Yeah! It's worth every penny.
How many? 10, 20, or more?
Last year, Black.
Most people will stab you in the back as soon as they're looking. There's a good few will stab you in the front.
Peace. One day they reckon. How long have we been saying that?
Nothing natural just pops up overnight. Well, you know what I mean. Something is supposed to and don't. I'm talking about the temples, okay?
Gotta get them. Makes sense, doesn't it? If you think about it.
The market's saturated with artifacts. This stuff would have sold for a fortune on the mainland.
Saw it years ago. Not seen it since. Dreamt of her, not seen her.
Lady Luck's sure in my direction.
I heard he and her were, you know, don't know whether he's lucky or she's blind.
Sonia tossed him out on his ear, said he couldn't pay for a service in life.
You're telling me. I mean, it's not that I don't believe you, but.
You seem to have the trainees here under control.
Most have had hard lives and tough breaks. We always need fighters, and I can't see that changing anytime soon. Staff fighters, sword fighters, any kind. They'll all be needed, mark my words.
So you don't always fight with the staff?
It wasn't where I started. I'm originally a sword fighter, you know. Sword handed down through generations of my family.
Really?
Yeah, family is important, you know. I mean, don't get me wrong, the staff is a fine weapon. With a good sword in my hand, I defy any man to stand against me.
But only as long as you have a good sword, right?
Well, I mean, of course the sword is important, but the person who wields it, that's where the true strength lies.
Really?
See me, lad? I expect I could knock you down with a rusty sword.
You could beat me with a lousy sword.
If you had one here, lad, I'd show you.
I do have a pretty bad sword, but I don't think it's fair to challenge you in your state.
My state? I could beat you twice as drunk and half as ready. You take my sword, I'll take yours, and I'll still beat you. Come on, lad, let's go to the arena. I'll show you who's in a state.
I'm ready for you this time.
Let's see. If you are, then maybe you're ready for what's out there, too.
I think I'm giving myself something. They're hurt anyway.
I've heard that too.
Careful with that weapon.
You don't know who you are.
Yeah, get out of here! Huh?
Does that make me the master now?
Ha! Keep that up for 5 or 6 more years, and then, maybe, you did well. You're a natural with the staff.
Thanks.
As far as I'm concerned, you're ready for whatever this place tries to throw at you. Go and see Vitus, and good luck to you. Not now.
Sonia's this month. I hear there are some real sweetmeats to taste down there. Refugees, with no money. Fresh fish.
They're everywhere. The blade's to be sharp, that's very important.
Stop there, brother. Hey, you can't enter here.
I don't want to fight, but I can't let you in.
I hope it doesn't rain. I've had enough rain.
Some things are supposed to and don't, and...
What?
Quiet. I'm thinking.
Gotta get them. Makes sense, doesn't it? If you think about it.
My basic training is complete.
A warrior's training is never complete. Do not forget that. However, you have shown discipline. It's now time to take your training further. Vince will allow you into the upper parts of the monastery. Go now, and continue your training.
Tell me about the other masters.
You have already encountered Master Pallas. He received you at the gate. You will find the other masters in the upper part of the monastery. Ilumar can teach you how to write scrolls. Cyrus deals with artifacts from the temple ruins. Ignatius the Wise you will find in the Holy Hall. Master Abrax, our alchemist, goes where he wishes.
And all of them will train me.
This is a place of learning. All the masters revere knowledge.
I have proved myself to Dalman. I have earned his trust.
In times of battle, it is important to know whom one can trust. And I fear battle is what awaits us.
Don't bother me.
Halt. Stranger.
I've finished my training. I have permission.
Then you can enter the upper area of the monastery.
I've advanced my training.
Good. Training is vital. I have here a list. This list names all those who has permission to leave the monastery recently.
That will be a great help.
Good. Then continue your investigation.
I'm not listening.
What can you teach me? Help me improve my dexterity.
Good.
Help me improve my dexterity.
You're learning.
Never mind.
What?
Take that pretty face somewhere else.
I need some rest.
Did you know Hemlar?
Of course. This is a small place. Not knowing someone is damn difficult.
Did you have much to do with him?
No. He just got his staff and...
And what?
Well, now and again he sold people some brugelweed. Everyone knew what he did. It was the monastery's worst kept secret.
What can you tell me about Hemlar?
Hemlar? Never got to know him. He's been here longer than us, so he didn't talk to new recruits.
You must know something about him.
Well, he spent a lot of time with Harlock in the kitchen.
And?
Harlock isn't the sort that talks much, but apparently the two of them had things to talk about. But you'll have to ask Harlock what it was.
Palace gave me a list of everyone who can leave the monastery.
Let's have a look then. One of these people must have been Hemlar's partner. I don't know. Could be any one of them. You'll have to get them on their own, see what they know. Enzo and Ash are in the upper area of the monastery during the day though. You're going to have to wait until nightfall to talk to them. That's when they return to their chambers. Unless you manage to finish basic training, then you'll get access to the upper monastery.
What about you? You're on the list.
You think I'd risk getting caught doing that? You stick out and cause trouble here, you get sent to the ruins.
You could be lying.
Yeah, but I ain't. Come on, would I be helping you if I was? You can keep questioning me, but you'll be wasting your time.
Tucker says you talked with Hemlar. Quite often.
He came here a lot, yes. He liked good food.
Good food?
Yep, if you want to know. We talked about cooking. Stews, soups, pastry, meat. Hemlar wanted to be a chef.
You expect me to believe you were exchanging recipes?
Believe what you like.
What do you know about Hemlar?
Hemlar? Grumpy git. Always sneaking about.
You didn't like him?
Most of us who bought from Hemlar didn't like him. Just what he sold. Dealing with Hemlar was just a necessary evil.
What did he sell?
Brugelweed. Smokes. Inflated prices, though. He knew it was hard to get in here.
You seem annoyed.
Well, he went and got himself murdered, didn't he? So now, no Hemlar, and no Brugel either. I'm sure you have things to deal with. Ah, a recruit who knows the value of both the spell and the staff.
And who are you?
My name is Enzo. I too am a seeker of knowledge.
Found any yet?
Indeed. The books are very illuminating. You will learn much from them.
Books, knowledge. I'll remember that.
And I also advise you not to try entering the Holy Hall if you do not have permission.
Why?
Do you see those guards? Well, their fists are what you'll get if you're lucky. If you're not, you'll get that and punishment detail. I strayed, and now I must sweep the floors instead of studying.
Well, maybe you'll find enlightenment in that.
You think so? Really? Then I must devote myself harder to it.
Do you know much about Hemlar?
I believe he is one of the recruits. He once tried to sell me some Brugel, but I did not wish to receive enlightenment that way.
You! Yes, you. I've got a job for you. Tell Severin to send the next delivery. Got that?
Severin? Who's he?
Severin runs the artifact collection camp at a place known as Tilda's Farm. It's on the way from here to Harbour Town. Tell Severin to send the next batch of crates up here.
I'll find Severin.
If Severin has identified any special artifacts, he should give them to you. You bring them to me immediately.
Will Severin just give me these objects?
Why shouldn't he?
He doesn't know who I am.
Perhaps you want a password to give him. The blackbird sang gently in the night. Beware a squirrel in your underrobes, something like that.
That might work.
Right. Tell him this. If you don't send the artifacts, I'll rip your head off. How about that?
That sounds clear enough. I can't leave the monastery.
Well, you better make sure you can.
What is it you do here?
I am in charge of the artifacts. I see everything our recruits bring out of the ruins. Everything. These are the key. The key to finding out why the ruins rose up from nowhere, to explaining the storms. It's important work. Any magical items must be brought here. They must be processed.
And if I go, will you give me a magical item?
No.
Not even a little one?
Why should I give something to you? You've done nothing for me.
What's in those chests?
Silver and gold, jewelry, junk. Nothing significant.
Can I have some of the gold and silver junk?
No, it belongs to the Order. There are those who value junk, and we may need to bend such superficial greed to our purpose.
Yes, we couldn't have anyone's superficial greed being satisfied without authorization. We make a deal.
A deal? Finish your tests first. You are too easily distracted from them.
There's something here about magic.
You another recruit of the Inquisition?
I'm guessing you're not a volunteer.
I volunteer through press ganging, by order of the Inquisitor.
What happened?
Bad luck. I was out hunting wolves when a white-robed patrol passed. Some of us got away. They caught me.
You're a hunter?
Yes, but nobody here cares that I can handle a bow. Here I'm just recruit Jervis. They want me to learn star fighting and magic. I'm hoping by the time I've learned the magic I have to study, the Inquisition won't need me at the ruins.
Can you teach me about archery?
From what I've heard, there's nothing I know that you don't.
Hello. My name is Erlan. Did you get conscripted too, or did you decide to come here?
They caught me.
Me too. But I'm glad about it now. It's the best thing that could have happened. You'll find that.
Why is being conscripted good?
Before I came here, I was a nobody. I've got so many opportunities now. This place will stop you being a nobody too. And we get enough to eat, a warm bed at night, and best of all, to learn about magic.
Which path did you choose?
I'm going to be accepted in the Order as a warrior.
That's the path I chose.
You'll be in the middle of the tests as well, then. I'm working on a Lumar's test. You don't happen to know the ingredient you need for the Nautilus Scroll?
No idea. Sorry.
If you find out, please let me know. It might be worthwhile for us to share knowledge.
Which spells do you know the ingredients for?
Joke and telekinesis.
The rune table. The rune table is a powerful tool. Blah, 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 blah. Here's something. To prepare the rune table, place the desired rune in the table. There, that's it. Scroll preparation. The scroll maker prepares himself mentally, then places the ingredients, the blank roll of parchment, and the quill alongside the prepared rune table. Copy the rune, noting all strokes and details made by the rune maker. The rune table is the secret, then.
What's this? Are you a new student?
That's right.
Good. We are in great need of new minds.
Just teach me what I need to know. Give me my test.
Impertinent, aren't you? Well, I suppose I was at your age.
I want to learn from you.
Very well. I am Master Illuma. I teach the high art of creating scrolls. I need men who will fight for the Order of the Holy Flame and who will win. We are facing great dangers. I need the best and the bravest. Have you prepared yourself mentally?
What must I do?
Look at the bookstands in this room. They contain the principles of creating scrolls. Read and absorb. Read and absorb. Once you have read and absorbed these books, seek me out.
May I take the test?
Once you are ready. The test requires you to create a scroll and you must do it on your own. You may take the test once you are able to do that.
Master, I have learned the principles.
Have you indeed? Then you won't mind a couple of little questions. How do you prepare a rune table?
By inserting the rune stone.
What materials are needed for a scroll?
A prepared rune table, a blank roll of parchment, a quill, and the ingredients.
Good. You have learned.
Can I take the test now?
No. First, you must expand your theoretical knowledge.
Sounds easy enough.
Don't be hasty. Theory forms the foundation of all research. You would do well to absorb all knowledge and to memorize it.
Will you give me a quill?
Alas, part of your task is to obtain the components you will need. Obtaining the components is a skill as important as the scroll making itself. Perhaps the other students will help you.
What is my assignment, Master Illuma?
You already know that every spell has its magical ingredient.
So you want me to...
Do not interrupt. You will learn the ingredients for every spell for the first runic seal. That is your task. Find me when you have done that.
I'm working on my test for Master Illuma.
I'm working on that too. That's why I wanted to enter the Holy Hall.
What's in the Holy Hall?
A couple of book stands. I'd gone there to find out what ingredient I needed for an illusion scroll.
I really need a quill.
Of course. I have a spare. But good quills are rare. I must request a great deal of coin in return.
I thought you were just interested in enlightenment.
Yes, and I have been enlightened by the knowledge that rare objects equal much gold.
Do you know the ingredients for a Nautilus scroll?
Yes, why?
I need it for my test.
Well, then you must offer me something in return.
What do you want? Gold?
No. I wish for knowledge. I must know what is needed to create an illusion. Get that information, and I'll tell you what I know.
I am Master Ignatius, and you are... You have completed your basic training. But there are still challenges ahead of you.
Does that mean you want to set me a test?
It means I wish to show you something.
Hey, have you passed Master Illuma's test?
Yes, he given it to you too. I found it exhausting.
Do you know the ingredients for the spells in the first circle?
I did, but I can't remember. It was ages ago.
He must remember something.
I suppose I should remember them, but I was smoking quite a lot at that time.
Come on, please think.
I'm thinking. No, I can't remember. But I got help from Master Abrax. Maybe you could.
Who's Master Abrax?
The alchemist.
But you know something about it.
It's tough to find your way down there in the dark, but I remember where the entrance is.
Where is the entrance? Tell me.
It's hidden in the library. Search there and you'll find it.
There's really a hidden cellar.
Yes. Abrax is a great one for keeping out of the way. You'll have to pass his test to be accepted. Many novices had trouble finding Abrax. He's not exactly sociable.
Did you know Hemler?
Not really. He was a friend of Harlech's. If Harlech has friends, that is.
Why shouldn't Harlech have friends?
He's a pirate. I heard he was once cook on the Eleanor. Cook, dishwasher, and on-board psychopath. He's utterly evil. A killer who doesn't care.
But he got on with Hemler.
Even killers don't kill everyone. Suppose even they need friends.
What's the Eleanor?
The Eleanor's a ship. She belongs to the worst pirate on the Nine Oceans. Captain Gregorius Emmanuel Steelbeard.
Steelbeard? Can you tell me about him? Anything other than his name?
Yes. Stay out of his way. They say he was seen in Harbour Town not long ago. Who knows what he was doing?
Right.
Stay behind me.
Get out!
Where are you?
Yeah, bye-bye.
Stay behind me.
What plans do you have for me?
This is the library. These books contain much wisdom. Once you have read these books and learned the ritual that opens the door to the convocation, then we will talk again.
Hey.
Recruit.
Would you mind if I looked at that book?
By all means. I need to rest my eyes in any case.
This text is about magic spells. Interesting. What are you doing here?
I'm looking for a book.
Any book in particular?
It's called Wisdom in Combat. The monastery is supposed to have a copy.
You like reading?
Yes, I read a lot. And write a lot.
You write books?
Books, no. Scrolls. I make sure the Order always has enough healing scrolls. I spend most of my time doing that, actually. In the writing chamber. Oh, and I also train and practice with the crossbow.
The crossbow?
We don't use them in warfare. But the truth is, I'm damn good at it. And I enjoy it.
Are you good enough to train me?
You don't hold back, do you? But yes, I can train you.
What can you teach me? Can you tell me the components for light healing?
Of course. Many here are wary of strangers. But with the chaos going on, I say we're all in this together. I mean, you don't look like a spy. But spies don't, do they?
It's for Master Illumar's test. That's why I need the ingredients.
Ah, so you are certainly one of us. Well, you're working on it. I'm looking for Wisdom in Combat. If you'd be able to bring me that book, I'll tell you everything about the scrolls.
Here, about scrolls and ingredients. Preparing a telekinesis scroll requires wing dust. Who could teach me to pick locks? There's something here about magic. That's impossible. This text is about magic spells. The mage places himself in a floating state. He moves only with the power of his mind. As long as he concentrates, heights can also be overcome. However, this requires more concentration. Now, who could teach me to pick locks? Telekinesis. The power of thought can move matter, allowing a mage to move objects towards them from a great distance. Switches and levers which are far away can also be activated. That's something to know.
who could teach me to pick locks. There's something here about magic. How do you write scrolls? Now who could teach me to pick locks? Now who could teach me to pick locks? I knew that. There's something here about magic. This text is about magic spells. Something here about magic. This text is about magic spells. There's something here about magic. A magic barrier. That's impossible. Interesting. There's something here about magic. This text is about magic spells. Now who could teach me to pick locks? Interesting. Nothing new. Who could teach me to pick locks? This text is about magic spells. Here, any mechanical lock can be opened by the will of the mage, regardless of how complicated they are.
Nothing new. Nautilus spell produces a shell of energy that rolls around the mage casting it. The mage transforms, shrinking so they may enter small spaces. That could come in handy. About magic spells.